Hello and welcome to the weekly Kashmir University Video Digest Quest. First, a look at the highlights. Chancellor visits university, inaugurates new buildings. DECA holds one-day workshop. And some important notifications from the university. Now the details with your host, Beenish Ali. Governor of the state and the Chancellor of the University of Kashmir, Mr. Narendranath Vohra, visited the Institute of Kashmir Studies where he held interactions with the students, scholars and faculty of the institute. Vice Chancellor Professor Khurshid Iqbal Andrabi, while welcoming the Chancellor, thanked him for taking out time for an interactive session.
In that context, I requested you to have a formal interaction with the faculty, and you were kind and gracious enough to say that you would come over to the institute yourself. We actually started with about 11 programs. Now we have zeroed in on 3. They will highlight the prospect and the pros and cons of those programs. With your guidance and with your wisdom, we would place one in the academic council and have the academic program launched from this year itself. With those words, I thank all of you, because it's a brief function and plus there we don't have any air-conditioned facility here.
Mr. Vohra, who is also the chairman of the governing body of Institute of Kashmir Studies, then interacted with the students, scholars and faculty members. The Chancellor advised scholars not to focus excessively on marginalized communities.
I would say that here in this institute, let us not focus excessively on identities, marginalized communities. Have a larger spectrum where you can create some positive outcome. My own perception is that when we focus excessively, I have seen some writings on marginalization, identities, they create a negative outcome. Mare gaye, lut gaye, khatam ho gaye. Now you have to create also a message which is founded in academic research, but which is some hope and symbol for the future.
He expressed surprise that the university students, scholars and faculty members have become insensitive towards the decaying Dal Lake.
Jaise Dal Lake hai, ye 3 mahine mein proposal banna chahiye. Because you see, these are pressing issues. I have come this side after a long time. I've never seen the lake so bad and so dirty. But some or the other, we have no sensitivity. I would suggest you start studying. Why do people living in Kashmir, living in Srinagar, have become insensitive to what the lake looks like? Why has the Char Chinar died? Why the trees have died, nobody is shedding a tear? Koi humari ownership to nahi hai na. It's been very sad. If all the sewage in the surrounding area flows into the Dal, no students' community of Kashmir University, no teachers' community, no civil society, I haven't seen a single statement. Why does that happen? Ye bhi thoda dekhna padega ki what has happened to our sensitivity.
On the same day, Chancellor and Governor of the state inaugurated 2 blocks of the Sheikh Ul Alam Hostel for Men at the university's Zakura campus. He also took a round of the hostel blocks and viewed the facilities provided to the hostel students. The Directorate of Internal Quality Assurance organized a day-long workshop on choice-based credit system. The workshop was aimed to review implementation of CBCS at the university, highlight its objectives, and identify operational difficulties. Coordinator DECA, Dr. Adil Bashir, while conducting the proceedings of the function, said that every new thing is laced with various issues, which are sorted out with time.
We all know that the higher education institutions globally has witnessed a tremendous change. If you go to European universities, they have adopted the credit-based system. In UK, Japan, similarly in India also, the choice-based system has been adopted by means of the recommendations of the 11th five-year plan and the National Knowledge Commission. The University Grants Commission adopted it, and similarly it had to adopt it by all the universities of the country. We all know that what choice-based system is, but still there are challenges and issues which need to be addressed. We have moved from the annual system to a semester system. There is maximum liberty to the student to select, to choose a subject of his choice, which previously was not. And there were limitations in the previous or the traditional approach of teaching learning system. In order to understand this and what are the issues, what are the gaps, we have organized this one-day workshop on choice-based credit system.
Chief Coordinator DECA, Dr. Manzoor Ahmed Shah, told participants that the workshop has been organized for cross-fertilization of ideas so that CBCS is improved.
When a new policy is introduced in the academic system, like university system, which is at a quite departure from the previous traditional system, there are issues expected. Resistance to accept the new things is also inherently a problem. And then there are other issues as well. So with the passage of now more than three years having this choice-based credit system introduced, we thought it is the appropriate time to have basically a kind of platform where all of those people who really want to share their concerns about this system are on board, and we brush our shoulders together, have some sort of free and fair discussion about the positives and the negatives of the choice-based credit system. And I must tell you, the objective of this workshop is not to basically criticize only what we have been doing, so that with the common experiences, with the cross-fertilization of ideas, we come to some sort of a better alternative framework or some sort of good suggestions that will be implemented in the overall scheme of things so as to improve the quality of academic discourse.
Dean Academic Affairs Professor Musaddiq Amin Sahaf, while critically evaluating the CBCS, said that the university has been able to perform better than several other universities.
Indian universities are unique examples where they opted for a particular component of the system. Rest they kept the same. The traditional system, examination system, they kept the same. The instructional methodology, they kept the same, and thought that by implementing this particular component, we would achieve success, which is practically impossible because that system has its own basis. How the traditional system and the choice-based can be put together and think in terms of some kind of output which will be even better than Americans. Either you adopt the entire system along with the instruction where you have to continuous assessment, now we are shifting to that, we are still better. If we compare ourselves with the rest of the country, They are not changing the evaluation system. They are not changing the instructional methodology. Sital Kashmir University has achieved a lot of. There are operational problems, no doubt. We have been working on that. There are operational problems. But Sital, the level of achievement is much higher than rest of the universities of the country.
In his presidential address, Vice Chancellor Professor Khurshid Iqbal Andrabi opined that introduction of every new system needs time to sink in, and the university has done a good amount of justice with the CBCS.
Evolution of attitude takes decades, takes generations. It doesn't happen overnight. By wearing clothes like Americans, do we think we have become Americans? We would never. Those are 16th generation educated people. We are barely second generation educated. So what we want to do now, because the world has become global, we want to catch up and compensate for 200-year difference between the Western countries and the Indian scenario. And that is why it has created problems. But then, as I said, it is UGC, it's imperative, we have to follow it regardless. And then make the best of this situation as well. And I am sure, I honestly tell you, that we still have made best of the situation. We have, in a short span of time, done small tinkering here, tinkering there, and sort of made the whole system more or less receptive to this choice-based grade system. And it has come to a point where we have done reasonable justice to the core programs, we have given reasonable comfort to the examiners. As Saab Saab said, that the evaluation system has also been put in tune with what choice-based grade-based system demands.
Congratulating the teachers for putting in extra efforts, Professor Andrabi, however, cautioned them that success is not to be measured with the result of few years.
It cannot happen all of a sudden. We cannot evolve to a point where people have been using this system for the last 40 years and we immediately start believing that we'll evolve to a point that it becomes operational exactly as it is operational in the West. But the intent, as I said, is very good. And the system is all receptive to any kind of change that happens here, we'll have it accommodated there. So it's not like it's a one-sided affair. We are all working to make it a successful story, and that is why this seminar, and I must really congratulate these guys to get more inputs, get more participation from people, where you want it to be tinkered, where you want it to be sort of fine-tuned, where it would become better operational.
Deputy Director DECA, Mr. Shaukat Shafi, proposed the vote of thanks. Now some important notifications from the university. The Department of Earth Sciences is inviting applications for the post of Junior Research Fellow in the Ministry of Earth Sciences sponsored research project. Applications should reach the office by or before 22nd August 2017. The Department of Botany is conducting a walk-in interview for the Junior Research Fellows on 17th August at 10:30 a.m. in the Office of Dean Research. The candidates should bring original certificates, transcripts, documents indicating qualification and research experience in the relevant field on the day of interview. For further information, you can log on to kashmiruniversity.ac.in or kashmiruniversity.net. With this, we come to the end of today's program. In case you have missed some part of the program, you can log on to emmrckashmir.com where you can watch the whole episode. Do send us your suggestions at our email address quest@emmrckashmir.com. Leo Tolstoy wrote in his book, "Everything intelligent is so boring." That is certainly a thought to think about. With these words, I'll take your leave. See you next week. Goodbye.